So thank you for being in my space. And for this meditation, I would like you to have ready a journal and a pen, because if there is gonna be a staff coming and downloads coming during the meditation, you would like to record them and write them down after the journey. Also, the best will be if you can do it in laying down position or seated in meditation position, just seated. But if you are in your office and you're sitting on the chair, that's also okay. This meditation is gonna be a hero journey meditation. Hero journey meditation or heroine journey meditation, if you prefer to use a female activation. But regardless how you feel about, if you wanna call it hero, that's alright as well. But we are not gonna be here to slay dragons. It's gonna be more the inner wisdom journey than warrior slaying dragon one. So if you are comfy, if you are ready, if you are maybe laying down, or if you are just seated, let's start. Let's start with few breaths to connect us back to our body. Our bodies are our most divine connection, and our body is always the connection to the divine. So the breath is this connection as well. The breath is this reminder that we are divine. So let's breathe deeply and let's take the air all the way in, even feeling how this breath, how this air is moving through our body, is moving through all the pieces, all the parts, moving up and down. Let it flow, let it move freely. Let's don't put any intentions in the movement yet. Let's do another breath also with no intention, just moving freely the air, feeling where the air wants to go. Maybe now we can recognize some parts which are in the need of more air. Next breath. Now we know. Now we can feel in our body that there are parts which are needing a little bit more attention, a little bit more air, and we can go to those parts and breathe into it. And let's direct our breath again there. Let's do 5 breaths, 5 intakes, and 5 outtakes. Going to the spaces which are of need, of a little bit more attention. Maybe we can feel a tension in our heart, maybe we can feel a tension in our chest. Maybe there is some anxiety building up, maybe there is a little bit of stress. Maybe if we feel like we need to move the air towards our shoulders, our right shoulder, our left shoulder. Whatever you feel is needed today for you, just move it there. Now, for this now, next couple of breaths, we're gonna use these breaths to move a little bit deeper in and ground through our root chakra. So we're gonna take the air in and move it like all the way down, move it a little bit deeper, taking more air and moving it all the way down towards our root chakra, which is right on the bottom of our pelvis floor. We're just gonna go all the way there. We're gonna move the breath down there. Gonna work with 3 breath intakes, moving the air again all the way down to ground ourselves and to feel connection. One more breath. And one more. If we feel this little tingling, this little like a movement in the root chakra, this means that the root chakra is activated and we can go even deeper to ground ourselves and feel the connection through the ground, through the earth, going all the way to ground. All the way through the soil, all the way through the pavement, our root. We can imagine all the elements we are going through. And then we are just going through the rock parts, through the rocky parts, through the soil, through the stones, through the pebbles, all the way down to the core. And we ground there. It's a safe place with connection to our Mama Gaia. When we are there, when we are grounded, when we are activated, we're gonna go back up. And we're gonna start our hero journey with this visualization, with this guided visualization. Going first to this piece where we start our journey. Our journey will start in the big middle, this big middle, this big open space. Maybe it's a prairie with like those like a grasses, sandy colors, or we can see a green meadow, but we also see a path. We see this path, which is like white, maybe it's paved, maybe it's rocky. We can imagine this path. Gonna start our hero, our heroine journey with putting on the armor which is gonna protect us and the armor which is gonna be with us through the whole journey. This armor can be whatever we are imagining in this moment. It can be like a metal armor which is like protecting us. You can imagine like a gold armor protecting our body. We can also go and imagine that this is like just like this big ball of light embracing our body, going over our chakras, going over our aura and protecting our body in this beautiful bubble of gold light. So this is our armor. We are ready to embark on our hero journey. And regardless of the material we've picked for our armor, this armor is super light. So we feel light, we don't feel heavy. Even if we picked metal, if we picked gold metal, or if we picked different silver metal, we are still really light, and this journey, it's like, it's a light journey, it's not like a heavy armor. We start to walk the path. Start to walk the path, seeing how the imaginary on both sides is changing. The imaginary of both sides is changing, and we see different like little towns, different villages, different like a bra, different bushes, different shrubs, different trees. But this pathway is still leading us through this journey, through this hero journey. And we can imagine how this pathway is beginning to be a little bit more rocky. It's beginning to feel more like there is a little bit of tension when we walk it. And we are maybe walking a little bit more up, maybe it's more like a hike we are going, but we feel like there is like some resistance. We feel this resistance in our body when we are walking. And this resistance in our body is showing, it's showing in some places as well. So if we feel this resistance in our body during this journey, we can always direct our breath right away to this place where we feel the resistance. The resistance can show in like a little bit of tightness in our chest again. It can show in the shoulders, in the hands. It can show in our hips. If we remove this resistance with the breath, we can just direct with this lovely attention and just bring this breath, and the resistance is gonna go. So we walk slowly, we walk more, we walk through the pathway, we see how the rocks are getting bigger and bigger, and now we're gonna need to climb. So we are climbing those rocks, we are climbing, we are going up. We see there is something there, but we don't know what it is. Maybe this is something we experienced as a child and we still can remember. Maybe it's a person who hurt us, or a person who neglected us. Maybe it's a school bully. Maybe it's a parent or parental figure. Whoever there is, this is not a pleasant surprise. This is not a pleasant view. This is not a pleasant image. But we don't see it clearly yet. We see this, it's a little bit like foggy. It's like just kind of like showing, appearing, but then it's disappearing. And we know there is still like this, like a distance, the distance which we have to go through to actually meet this place. The distance may be like a little blurry, but now, to our surprise, we see clearly that there is this one person just waving to us, waving to us, the person who is a friend, the person who is our lover, the person who is our teacher, or whoever we pick. But this is a safe person. This is our safe person. Maybe it's a dog, it can be a pet. It can be our spiritual guide. It can be Jesus. It can be your angel. It can be whoever you feel it's safe And you know this person, you know this image is there to guide you and to protect you. You remember that your armor is protecting you as well. You remember that your armor is safely protecting you. It's with you. So now you don't only have your armor, you also have a person with you, your safe person, your guide, your friend, your spiritual guide, your spiritual teacher, who is there to guide you. You feel the hand of this person giving you a hand, giving you this connection. You are connected. Maybe it's just like a touch of the hands. Maybe this person is like embracing your shoulder to walk together. And now you feel extra protected, you feel extra safe, and you're gonna walk towards the foggy area on this mountain you are walking through. You see how the hike is going a little bit harder, but this person who is there to guide you is helping you, is giving you a hand, is helping you to go over the rocks. And you have this beautiful, safe, warm feeling that regardless what's there in the fog is waiting for you, your guide, your friend, your protector is gonna be there with you. And it's gonna help you. It's gonna help you to embrace this challenge. Embrace this challenge, embrace this rite of passage. So, you guys are walking together, walking through all these passages. Ready to face the challenge. If you feel a little bit of tension before you are closer to the challenge, you can breathe and connect back to your body. You can direct your breath to the places which are tense. And your guide, your teacher is there embracing you, holding your shoulders, holding your hand. You're safe and protected. When you're coming to the challenge and you are so close, you're so close that you should be able to see. You see that the challenge is actually disappearing in the fog. There is no more problem, there is no more trouble, there is no more challenge. It disappeared just in the front of your eyes. You didn't have to fight it, you didn't have to do anything. It just disappeared. It's gone. It's removed. You feel like the tension which was showing in your body when you approached the challenge is also gone. There's only lightness. You're protected with your gold bubble. And you see the clear path in the front of you. Clear and easy path. Built from the golden dust, which is embracing the mountain all the way to the top. And you're moving moving farther. And now you are ready to be fully free. You see how the challenge disappeared. You're moving forward on the gold dust. It's a wide highway built from the gold dust. And now you see even more guides, even more friends, even more pets, maybe spiritual teachers who are there for you on the both sides of those roads, both sides of the highway. They are there for you to hold you and help you with any challenges. Look forward and you see how the golden bubble still protecting you, the golden highway built from golden dust is wider and wider and wider. And you feel this warm feeling of safety. You're safe. You're safe in your body and you're connected to the divine. Always. If you feel like you want to add some movement now and wake up, you're welcome to do it. If you noticed what was the challenge showing up in the fog, maybe a person, maybe a thing, maybe an action which happened, then you can still work on this through the journaling, write it down. And if you want to come back to any of those meditations, you are welcome. And this meditation is to help you to realize and to help you to find your guides and safe space in your body. Thank you for listening. Welcome to the YouTube channel for more, and if there's any meditation you would like to hear, be welcome to share this with me because I love to hear your feedback.